So, welcome back everyone. We will start with the next session, which is on Moodle. So, the teacher use of Moodle, which is demonstrating the Moodle features from a teacher's perspective. So, what you have seen till now is that there were sessions on learning objectives, learning activities, assessment, and all of them were integrated in a lesson plan. So, what we are going to do now is how can we create a technology tool to implement your lesson plan, and that technology tool is Moodle. So, in this session, we will see the use of Moodle from the viewpoint of a teacher. And we will demonstrate 6 different activities that we did in the QEEE Moodle. So, what is Moodle? It is a free and open source learning management system. It is highly flexible and fully customizable, and it is designed for learners, educators, and administrators. So, it is not just for students and teachers, even administrators can use Moodle. Some technical details, a Moodle is available in multiple versions, the latest one being 2.7.1, and the Moodle team supports versions till 2.5.7, and it is available for Linux, Windows and Mac OS X setup. The QEEE Moodle that you are using is in version 2.6. An important thing in a Moodle is to set up user permission. There are 4 main levels of user permissions which are most common in many of the Moodle implementations. One is the administrator or the super user who sets up the course and the other adds members. Next is a teacher who is in charge of a course. Then there will be non-editing teachers or TAs. And the final is a student permission. The Moodle, the home page of Moodle is this. You can go to this website and see more information about Moodle from there. So, at the end of this session, there will be a hands-on activity wherein you will go to your lab and do some activities in a demo Moodle page that is available in this website. The details will be given to you towards the end of this session. So, before you proceed to the exact hands-on, we need to have an alignment of what you want to achieve and what you want to use in the Moodle. So, what you want to achieve is in terms of the pedagogic activity, and what you want to use is the tool within Moodle. So, Moodle has lots of features. Which of these will you use and for what purpose? So, this is a TPS activity. So, at your remote center, you have already done your lesson plan activity in the previous session. So, for your own course, individually identify what are the teaching learning activities that you are planning to conduct. You can refer to the lesson plan that you did in the previous session if you want to quickly take activities, and then prepare a list of 3 activities and the corresponding purposes. So, if you are doing a discussion in the class, why you are doing so? So, the activity is discussion and the purpose is I want to make collaboration in class. So, that could be a purpose. So, each of you will have, each center, you will have 3 minutes before which we proceed to the next phase. So, at this point, you can keep it at your end. The sharing phase will come later. Okay, next. Now, the pair phase. Share your activities with your partner, the activities and purpose, and together determine which of these activities can be done through Moodle and how. So, this is at this point, you know what all you did in QEEE Moodle. Assuming that you are familiar with that setup and you did all the activities, think of the ways in which you can implement your learning activities in Moodle. So you will be given 5 minutes to do this. So some participants are asking about resources. The session which was conducted earlier, day 4 AM1, the slides will be uploaded soon. So remote center coordinators, ensure that activity is happening within your remote center. People are pairing up and discussing the activity. So I would urge centers to start discussion and coming up with a list. Please do not sit idle. You have already done lots of activities in Moodle, so you can take a leave from that. So I see lots of responses coming in. So when you think of an activity, you will have to tell what exactly that, how exactly it will be implemented in Moodle. So if it is a flipped classroom activity, so is it a resource upload? So will there be a quiz? So that is the detail that we are asking you right now. So the final 2 minutes before we proceed to the share phase. Yes, quizzes can be used for independent understanding. Resource sharing through file uploads, yes. Assignment submissions, yes. So I think we can now move to the share phase. Although many of the remote centers are doing the share through chat. So what I want the remote center coordinators to do is share top 2 common users identified within your remote center. So I need 2 common users and the purpose for which these Moodle activities are being used. So it's not just the Moodle activity, we need the purpose for which this activity is used. So yes, so I can see visualization, sharing learning resources, discussion forum in Moodle on evaluating a design, posting a poll, yes. So how is concept mapping implemented in Moodle? Okay, I believe most of you have identified quiz. Then there is file sharing which has been identified. Okay, so one remote center is telling animation. So how is it implemented in Moodle? We need how that is going to be implemented in Moodle. Quiz, yes. Group discussion for collaboration. So how do you do the group discussion? Which Moodle facility feature will you use? Assignments, yes. Assignments for question answering, yes, that is right. Sharing of resources, yes. So I think most of you have identified the top major uses that we have used within the QEEE Moodle. Anyway, I'll repeat it, some of them. File uploads through the file resource which provides resource sharing. Then there are the news forums and discussion forums for collaborations and discussions. Assignments, quizzes, lessons, and feedback surveys. So all these features were used in the QEEE Moodle. We'll now see examples from the QEEE Moodle on how some of these users were implemented and explain the pedagogic purposes of each of these features. So first is adding a file. The purpose is for information transfer. So all the slides of the workshop or the worksheets, all these are uploaded in the Moodle. This is for information transfer. It is an easy process, like attaching the files to an email. So what you have to do is, step one, there will be a button called add an activity or resource when you log into Moodle as a teacher. You have to click this. Then the next window will show you the options. So under resources, you can see that file is there and the explanation of what this is given on the side. You select that, then this screen is shown which shows add a new file to Moodle. So you have to give the name of the file, the description, so what is contained in this file, and you can see this. Either you can do the normal upload from the folder, or you can drag and drop files from your local folder to this Moodle folder. So within the QEEE Moodle, you have seen lots of files being uploaded, and the file upload as a resource is possible only for a teacher. Students can upload files only if only for assignments. So the information sharing purpose, for information sharing purpose, files can be uploaded only by a teacher. And there were the size of a file, all those restrictions are set at a admin level, and basically you can then go and choose the way in which this file will behave. So whether it can be shared across the permissions, copyright permissions, all these can be set within the Moodle. So what I'll just show you how this is going to be done in the QEEE Moodle. It's a small demonstration. So what you see right now is the QEEE workshop Moodle. I'm going to log into it. So you can see that I'm logged in, and all these features are there. So to add a resource, I just click turn editing on, and this is the button that I talked. So for each the appropriate week, I just go and click add an activity or resource, and in this list, then you see a list. From that list, I go to resources and select file. If I say add, so I see the settings. Now from my, I'll say sample file upload, and I can use any file from this and drag and drop. You can see that file over there. You can rename the file, set the author, what kind of license it is, all these can be set in this. So now that you have seen the file, I'll just put a recall level question. An AV poll will be set up now. Who sets the file upload size for a Moodle course? Now that you have seen it, teacher, student, non-editing teacher, or Moodle administrator. So who has the permission to set the file upload size in a Moodle course? We'll start the poll now. So at your remote center, the poll has been enabled. Remote center coordinators. So I see a lot of people already giving the answer. So I'll see the results. Okay. So two remote centers have said A, the teacher, and all the others have said D. Let us see what the correct answer is. Yes, it is D, the Moodle administrator. Teacher just uploads the file. He does not have any permissions to set any file size permissions except when it is an assignment. So in a general information sharing mode, it is the Moodle administrator who sets up the file size permissions. You have done lots of activities in the QEEE Moodle. Now the question is, what is the maximum upload limit for a file in QEEE Moodle? So what did the Moodle admin set this up in the Moodle? You can share the answers through chat. So I see lot of people. So if you recall the various activities, there were some activities wherein we explicitly stated the file size. Okay, I see D's, I see C, lots of D's, 5 MB. So this is a recall level question. I'll just show you the answer. It was 5 MB. Remember, during the video upload assignment, we had instructed that the file size should be less than 5 MB, because Moodle will not handle any files above that. So that is about the file upload. So now we'll move in the same fashion. We'll show you the screenshots of the Moodle feature, then we'll show you an actual demonstration within the QEEE Moodle. So it is the next feature that we are looking at is assignment. So the learning activities purpose of the learning activity is for assessing learning. So assignments can be of multiple types, can be a file upload assignment, can be an online text entry. You ask something and they respond in answers, and also it also can be an offline activity. The QEEE Moodle allows group assignments because it is of the version 2.6. Assignments can be set up to target all the 6 levels within the revised Bloom's taxonomy. And again, like the file upload, it is an easy process to construct it. Step 1 is always the same, add an activity or resource. Then when that list comes, you select the assignment and the type of assignment that you want. So this assignment module is assignment 2.2 module. So if you want uploading of files, a single file, you can select upload a single file. If there are multiple file upload, then you can choose advanced uploading of files. Once that is clicked, you have to provide, then the screen will come about the assignment settings. You will have to compulsorily give the assignment name and a description. These are the some of the other settings: availability, submission types, feedback types, submission settings, grade and common module settings. I'll just briefly show you one assignment. So I'll just select an assignment which was, it is there in Moodle. So this assignment is of type 2.2. So you can see the assignment name is planning a wiki activity for your course. The description has been provided. The dates, 24 July to 27 July, the time. So prevent late submissions. I have checked it as no, which means that you can submit even after this deadline. The grading method, since this is a single upload file, there is a setting for upload a single file. Over here you can see maximum size setting. So teachers can decide the maximum size upload in assignments. And common module settings is whether it is visible in the Moodle course, what kind of groups is it following, and all the other details. So now that you have seen how the assignment looks like, a simple question: will Moodle accept delayed submissions? You can poll this in through AView. There are three options: yes, no, and depends on what teacher has set. So I see all the remote centers answering C. Okay, there is a remote center which said B. So let's see what the answer is. So yes, it depends on what the teacher has said. So you can even accept delayed submissions. You can set, have the settings like that. So if you go to that delayed submissions, yes, then Moodle will not accept delayed submissions. So it is up to the teacher to decide whether he or she wants to accept delayed submissions from the students. Okay, this I will do through AView poll. So the question is, can we enable group assignments within Moodle? A, yes. B, no. C, depends on the version of Moodle. So the polling has started, so answer through the poll. Okay, this is an interesting figure. You have 14 remote centers saying A, which is yes. One remote center saying no, and 12 saying that it depends on the version of Moodle. So remember what I talked about group submissions when I explained this right just a few minutes back. It actually depends on the version of Moodle. So 2.6, 2.5 onwards, they have enabled group assignment submission, but for a lower version, this particular setting was not available. So it the group assignment settings depends upon the version of Moodle that you will be using in your place. Now next is the quiz activity. So the learning purpose, the learning activity's purpose is for assessment. It can be set up to test all 6 levels of revised Bloom taxonomy. Setting up is tricky because you will have to have a plan on what Bloom's level you will be targeting, what kind of questions you will be you want to set up, because there are multiple options in which the answer can be received. It can be an MCQ, can be even a match the following, can be a short answer, it can be essays. So setting up of this activity is a bit tricky. Normal setup is the same. You select add an activity or resource, then the quiz activity is shown. You have to select the quiz activity and the general settings of the quiz is displayed. So what I'll show you is how one of the quizzes within the wiki was set up. So you have online assignment week 5. So this is the quiz 1 modified for wiki course. You can see name was given, a description was given, the timing for which the quiz was open, how the grade would be grading will be done, layout, how many questions per page. So this is question behavior. So this is important. So will there be random questions? So within, if you give a set of questions, will it be shuffled for every other user? So I have disabled this. And questions, how do questions behave? So this is important because you can see there are multiple options: adaptive mode, deferred feedback, immediate feedback, interactive with multiple tries. So there are multiple options of providing feedback within a quiz. And you can see that review options. So this is the review options for the student, what all he'll be able to see after during the attempt, immediately after the attempt, and later while the quiz is still open. So you can select whichever you want, what all feedbacks you want to give to the student while he or she is submitting the quiz, and what all he or she should be able to see after the submission of quiz. Then this is about display, and there are extra restrictions on attempts. So this will be like password, will it be requiring network address. So if multiple attempts are allowed, will there be a delay? So all those things, browser security and other things, and is it visible? So the common modules and settings, which shows whether it is visible or not. And as a teacher, you can see the attempts, how many have actually attempted the quiz. So now that you have seen a brief of this, let's do a small recall activity. Which of the following is not possible to set in a quiz? So I'll receive the answers through chat. So the first is feedback based on answer, feedback on marks, feedback about correct answer, and feedback about answers of other students. So yes, lots of colleges are entering the answer, and yes, you are right. As a student, feedback about answers of other students will not be possible in a quiz. If we were to enable multiple attempts for a question, can the teacher provide settings for a delay between two attempts? So again, I'll receive the answer through chat. Yes, no, I am not sure. Okay, seems like most of you were watching the demonstration correctly and following it. The answer is yes. So people who are not sure, there can be, it is possible that a delay can be set up between two attempts. It comes in the additional settings, which was shown towards the bottom of the page. Extra settings for the quiz. So you can set up a time delay between two attempts of the quiz. So next, we are looking at a feedback survey. So what purpose does a feedback survey give you? As a teacher, it provides you a formative assessment on how the class is going on, There are two types of feedback surveys, a standard learning survey, and there are custom surveys. So it is done through feedback module. We have used these custom surveys as pre-workshop survey, as wiki survey. So you saw a wiki survey activity yesterday. So this was done through this feedback module. You can set up feedback module for providing anonymous feedbacks. So if you feel that students will be hesitant to provide you feedback, you can set up the module to give you anonymous feedback. Again, the process is same. Add an activity or resource, you select feedback from here, and this is the window of feedback. So it is very less options. So number of options is less. Name, availability, questions and submission settings, what happens after submission, and common module settings. We'll just see how the wiki survey was set up. Wiki survey is a feedback module. So when is it available? So if you wanted a short term feedback, you can set it up for the same day with short hour duration. So here you can see that you can give the option of anonymous or logging of usernames, allow multiple submission, auto number of questions. So what happens after submission? Show analysis page or not? What will be the completion message? And if there is a activity which you have to do immediately after this, that link can be provided over here. So this is about survey, and again, questions, setting up questions, you can see that the questions are provided. So I'll just show you some sample questions. So you can see that this particular question, it is a multiple choice rated question. So it is the type of question. So what do you mean by multiple choice rated? You can see that there are different scales. So if you want options like agree, disagree, so over here it is I cannot do this, I can do this with some assistance, can do this independently, I can teach this to others. So it's a scaled a typical feedback survey question. So this can be done through a multiple choice rated option. You can see within the content the different types of questions or the features of a survey that you can add. So apart from multiple choice rated, you have the standard multiple choice question, can give a longer text answer. If you want an open-ended feedback, that is also possible. Numeric answer like age, number of years of experience. So all these can be obtained through numeric answer. Then short text answer, if you are having a 10 word or a single line answer, you can choose the short text answer rather than the longer text answer. And you can see that question is going to come over here. You have to fill the question details and other things. So you will be able to do all this in your demo Moodle session, which will come immediately after this. So we saw a little bit about feedback. So the poll question for you is, what is the option that you will use to get a Likert scale type of response within the feedback? So what option are you going to give? Is it a longer text answer? Is it a multiple choice? Is it a multiple choice rated? Or is it a short text answer? So you can provide your answers through AVU chat. Most of you have identified the answer correctly. It is a multiple choice rated setting that you have to use. It is not a short text answer or a longer text answer. So this will automatically come over there. Now a much more higher level activity, which is the lesson, adding a lesson. Lots of troubles with the peer instruction lesson which was set up initially. So a lesson, as you would have observed, is for both information transfer and also serves as an assessment. So it is a pretty good module to use if you are planning to use a flipped classroom activity and you have a Moodle with you. So you can set up the instructions, go and watch this, then add the recall level question after that, and an assessment feature will automatically come over here. Important is that it is branched and guided. So based on the response of the student, you can guide him to separate sections within a lesson. So, remember within the flipped classroom activity, we had asked you options on whether you will be, whether you are likely to use flipped classroom activity within your course, and we had given you 4 options. Yes, definitely, then it depends on whether let me see the flipped activity constructor. Third was no, I won't be using it because video creation is time consuming, and finally was a definitely no. So we had channeled your responses based on what you responded. So people who said that yes, I am currently using it, we had asked you details on your existing implementation, and for people who said no, I won't be using it, we had asked you why you will, why the reasons why you are not going to use those, and some additional details about the flipped classroom activity session that we had conducted within the online within the synchronous session. So how to do a lesson activity? Again, the initial steps are the same, and this is how the settings are going to come, the appearance, the availability. So one important feature is the prerequisite lesson. So if you are having multiple lessons, and to complete lesson number 2, it is required that the student should complete lesson number 1, then you can give, set this up in the prerequisite. Then flow control within a lesson, grade, common module settings, and other things. So I'll just show you a brief demo of the flipped classroom lesson that we had. So it was online assignment week 4. You can see a branching icon is coming over here, activity recalling what you did for flipped classroom. So I look at the settings. So the availability, there were no prerequisite lessons, so I have not selected that. So flow control, allow student review. So this will be, if this is set yes, then you can go and see what you had attempted in the particular lesson immediately after you complete the lesson. So you can see that the following options are available: import questions, add a content page, add a cluster, add a question page. So these options are available. So cluster means a group, content page means, for example, see this, add a content page. So the page is about the week's activity and this lesson. So you are actually providing information over here. So these kind of, if you want to provide information or want to show them some text which they have to read or understand, then that is given through content page. And you can see the description, proceed towards recall segment. This will come as a button in the actual activity. So proceed to, what it does is, once this button is clicked, it goes to the section recalling what happened in online session. So this is actually again another content, and then there is multiple choice questions over here, and for each answer you can see where it is going to jump. So this is about branching and guiding within a lesson. We'll now move to the poll question. So which feature of a lesson activity allows you to present information about the topic in a lesson? So if you as a teacher want to provide information about the topic to the learner, what kind of lesson activity will you choose? Is it a cluster? Is it a question? Will that be a content, or will that be a branch? So you can respond through AVU chat. So think about it, what was explained in this small demo. So I see a lot of A's and lots of C's. So let's see what the answer was. The answer is content. So you have to select the content option to provide information. Cluster is one in which you group a section of the lesson activity. Questions, as you know, are direct. Branches is when you want to divert. So after answering one, where do you want to branch? Okay. This is an exploratory question. Can a lesson be attempted by the whole class as a group? So I will. Okay, lots of people are responding through AVU. So the options are yes, no, depends on the group settings. There are lots of C's, depends on group settings. One or two A's. I saw no. Let me just show you what the correct answer is. So no, the lesson cannot be attempted by the whole class as a group, because we had already told you that lesson is supposed to be an individual activity. So you cannot have a grouping in a lesson. So you cannot have within Moodle a single person login is needed for doing a lesson. And you cannot, unlike assignments, you cannot have an entire group do a lesson by sitting in a group. Now the last is, you saw a common public wiki in wiki space yesterday. Moodle also has a wiki. So if you have done the optional assignment for the wiki activity, you would have seen that there was a QEEE resource wiki which was developed. The purpose was both, purpose of a wiki is for both information transfer and assessment. So it depends on how do you want to use it. Best for brainstorming, planning and collaborative writing. So the wiki that we did yesterday is for collaborative writing. So it is a collaborative activity, and you can assess all 6 levels of revised Bloom's taxonomy through a wiki. Within Moodle, it is a little tricky to set up, as there is some setting that you have to see in the individual and group settings. But if you want a private wiki which you want to share just with your students, then a Moodle wiki would be a good choice. But the only problem with that is that if you want to share this link to an external person, then it will be hard for the external person to see that wiki, unless and until he has a Moodle guest access to your Moodle. So the process is again same, add a resource, select wiki from the options. You will see, you can set up the wiki name, the description, the mode of wiki. So this is important. A wiki can be a collaborative wiki wherein everyone within the Moodle collaborates, or it can be an individual wiki which is between the teacher and a student. So it is a kind of a private wiki. This may be for a individual feedbacks. Let's say a teacher is, this is a distance mode of education, and teacher wants to discuss individual some details. The student puts up his own, creates an activity wherein student writes something, he has to provide a feedback, and both teacher and student collaboratively develops the content, then the individual wiki mode is used for that kind of wikis. So I'll just show you how the QEEE resource community, the QEEE resource wiki was created within the Moodle. So you go to the wiki week. Can see that wiki is community resources. So the wiki pages are being shown over here. Let me show you the settings. So this is the name of the wiki, the description. So this was given as a collaborative wiki. So the other options are individual wiki, which will be shown when you select a new wiki, and you can select a first page name. Okay. Now this is the way in which you edit in a wiki. A default format is HTML, which is HTML editor. You can actually force whether all the wiki pages are going to go in a HTML format. The other formats that are available are Creole and NWiki, which are standard wiki markup languages. So it will have a different format. So I'll just show you one. So this is done in a HTML format. This particular page, if you see, so this is in a NWiki format. So you have a separate syntax for writing. So if, when it gives us two equals, then it is a heading. So if you actually view, so there is a table of contents coming. The introduction is the big bold capital. There are screenshots. So all these have their own syntax within the editor space. So for this, you will have to learn this particular format. That was why it was not favored. So now back to the session. So again, a polling question. In a wiki module, how will you set up a common editor for all the wiki pages? So this is what you just saw. So some people are asking me what is guest access. So Moodle has a feature of providing guest access. So people who are not part of the wiki community, the Moodle community, can be provided guest access by giving them a separate login and information. So they will be able to access only that particular page which for which the teacher has provided them access. They will not be a student, nor they will be a TA. They will be just able to view the things over here, and also some settings can be done to upload files. But more or less, it is just viewing permission. Okay, so yes, most of you are right. So force formatting at settings page makes a common editor for all the pages. Okay, now this is the next question. You have to think a little. Assume that a teacher has created an individual wiki that is edited by the teacher and a student alone. So can other students see this wiki if the link to this wiki is provided in a collaborative wiki? So assuming that within Moodle there is one individual wiki and a collaborative wiki. So if I give the individual wiki's link within the collaborative wiki, will other students be able to view that individual wiki? Okay, so I am seeing lots of responses. So respond via ABU chat. Okay, one set is asking, telling about A yes and C students in same group can view. Let us see what the answer is. So the answer is no. An individual wiki is only the permissions for an individual wiki is only for the teacher and the student. So the moment you provide a link to that and another person clicks it, the Moodle system will throw an error that this is permission, you don't have permission or some appropriate error messages. So students in same group cannot view an individual wiki. So an individual wiki is only between the teacher and the student for whom the wiki is intended. Okay, so you have another half an hour. So the standard Moodle page has demo sites wherein you can act as a student, as a teacher and as an admin and create activities. So these two are two demo sites wherein you can try out. So we would urge all of you to go to your lab after this session or before the, then have the lunch, but do try out the standard Moodle demo sites in all the forms. The password is also given over here. So for this standard Moodle site, the password is sandbox, the username is provided over here, admin, manager, teacher, student. And for, and there is this site which is Mount Orange School. So this is also a demo site. The password for this user would be, teacher student user would be Moodle. And do note that this particular Moodle sites are refreshed every hour. So whatever contents you, you cannot save your contents permanently within this Moodle site. It will get refreshed after every hour. So the settings, the once you enter the Moodle site, a message on the top, the bottom right corner will show you how much time you have left for this session to get erased. So go ahead, try the Moodle demo. If you have a Moodle within your institution, then the perfect is try out various features within that Moodle. If not, go to these demo sites.